Let's talk about the Westchester departure at White Plains, right? So we're looking at White Plains HPN Westchester 7. That number is going to change every time they make a change on any of these departure procedures. So any of these procedures, it goes from 7 to 8, 8 or 9, and then it goes back to 1. So if this video gets outdated, it's just because the number has changed. But this is the Westchester 7. We're going to be using the JEP charts for this procedure, because we have seen that quite a few of our clients, they're not expecting a SID, right? A standard instrument departure, and it kind of becomes the deer with the headlight looks when ATC issues that to them, not knowing that, because if you're flying a G1000 airplane or something better, the information is here. And this is what we're going to talk about today. We're going to be loading it out of runway 16 at White Plains. This videos are not designed for you to watch them and go fly. Please seek instruction from a certified instructor. These videos are designed to give you some sort of homework, something to practice at home, to keep your head in the game before your next flight. They're not meant to be a standalone instruction. They're not meant to explain every single detail that is going on. Once you need instruction, visit our website, Aviator NYC. Okay, so I should also add, let me go back to this camera. I would also add, there are several elements into a standard instrument departure. We're only covering just the one of them, and that's kind of loading it and setting up the flight management system for that departure. If you do not understand about climb gradients, weather, how does it connect to the routing, the climb gradients, like we said, and everything else, just look for instruction. There's plenty of, or read the manuals. There's the instrument procedures handbook. There's everything explained for a professional pilot. You have to do the homework and seek instruction to get those criteria met for your airplane, for your flight training. All right, so let's get started. So we're gonna be loading the RNAV, now the SID out of runway 16 in White Plains. At the moment, we're kind of at the run-up area. You will do this once you get your clearance and you load your flight plan. For the purpose of this video, we're just going to load the departure procedure. So now, all I got to do is on the FMS, I will select flight plan. I'm sorry, procedure. Select departure. We're going to select White Plains, runway 16, load, right? So this is where it's going to get a little bit, let's talk about what the sequencing on this is, right? So here is the departure procedure out of 16. So the flight management system is gonna have us take off on runway 16, fly heading 163 to 800 feet, and then make a right turn to heading 320. This manual sequence is what we call it at the bigger airplanes, at discontinuity. What is gonna prevent is the flight plan to roll from 320 heading to the next waypoint. Because you don't want that. Because if you read the SID, it just tells you maintain 320. And then they will say on vectors to assign route or fix, right? So they're gonna maintain 320 until the 8 air traffic control will give you a new heading or direction of flight. That's what the manual sequence does, okay? So now we're gonna set our top altitude 3000. So one of the things with that is when ATC says climb via the SID is going to be 3,000. You're looking here on the top altitude, right? Let me see if I have the FAA chart handy. Yep, here we go. So notice how the FAA chart, and I'm showing you here, if you look on the bottom right, one thing to note, this video is 4K. So if you look up, increase the resolution, that way you can actually have a more detailed view. FAA charts are divided into two charts, right? And down here is where you will see that it will say 163, 800, climb and right turn 320, maintain 3000, right? JEP format is all in one chart, and it's just going to be primarily in this little box. Here, it does change it depending on the departure procedure, it does change the location, but that's what you're looking for in the initial climb. So we're going to set 3000 for the initial climb. 163 is runway heading, or very close to that. And then this is where, if you're flying a G1000 airplane, if it has a flight director, use it. It's there to help you, right? So generally, you may want to engage it as once you run the autopilot test, because if you set up the flight director and then run the autopilot test when you press disengage, the flight director is going to be giving you all this sort of guidance for whatever test you were running. So once you run the autopilot test, you more than likely will press TOGA. TOGA is a button generally around the throttle somewhere in the firewall, and all it does is take off, go around. And what it does, if you look at the PFD, it will set your flight director on the go around lateral mode, meaning left and right. And then vertical mode is going to be go around, which is generally 7.5 degrees. What? Because every time you press TOGA, you have to select the lateral mode. In this case, we have loaded the departure procedure on the flight management system, and our CDI is on GPS. Let me show you this. You see GPS terminal. Let me load the flight plan here just so we have it handy on the PFD. GPS terminal. Now on the autopilot mode selector, I'm going to select, or AFCS mode selector, how Garmin calls it. And then you see how it went from go around to GPS. Now that it's set up for the departure procedure, now your job will be just to be able to fly the flight director, and will help you maintain this course. It will actually help you maintain this headings instead of just turning 270-320. The flight management system, in help with the flight director, is going to be able to guide you, right? So that's how you set up the Garmin G1000, right, with the GFC 700. This procedure, for the most part, applies from a 172 with this system all the way to most airliners, because while the buttons are different, the logic may be slightly different, they're still following the same sequence, right? You always got to select the lateral mode. Once you take off, you're going to change it from go around to, if you prefer flight level change or you prefer pitch, you're going to select it into that mode and climb at the rate that you desired for the airplane you're flying. So, like I mentioned when we started this video, there's many factors to this instrument departure procedures. These are very hot topics for interviews, especially for instructors looking to become an airline pilot, because then it gets into kind of the briefing and all that sort of stuff. The scope of this video is just loading it and setting up the flight director on the G1000. We will have other videos where it talks about the briefing more complex departure procedures, because this is a very simple one. And keep an eye on them.